Welcome back to my channel. Today I will be showing you how to make Spanish omelette. So for this recipe you'll need a bowl, one onion peel, four potatoes peeled. I'm gonna peel them right now, and flour, six eggs. So what we're going to do first, we're going to take this onion and remove this out so you can see what I'm doing. We are going to cut this in half. Then, what we will do next is make sure to do the thinnest slices. Like this, let me show you close up.
Like that. See how small it is?
So we're gonna do the same thing with this guy, okay? We're gonna mince it, which means very small dice. And if you have a part that you can't use anymore, you're afraid to cut yourself, don't be afraid to throw it away. It's just a vegetable. We're going to do the same thing with this guy. Now, these onions are pretty strong, I'm not going to lie, but usually I don't have sensitivity to onions as much. This onion just doesn't give up, does it? So, if you want to make vegetable stock, you can preserve this and add it to a pot with more vegetables if you want to make vegetable stock. But in my case, I don't really need vegetable stock, so. Bring it up to you guys so you guys can see what I mean by small dice.
So this is what I mean by small dice. You see how small that is? Oops, some of it fell.
So yes. Then what you want to do with this, drop it into the bowl. Nice and easy. Just like that. Now you can put the cutting board away because you're not going to need to use it anymore. Okay. Now what we're going to do is clean the station from any onions that flew off the cutting board because you don't want to have any interruptions. Okay, so next task is put the knife away. We don't need no knife. You'll need a bowl or a plastic container to throw away this peels, the potato. So all you want to do is peel the potatoes. Now I personally prefer going this way than this way because you have more control and you would not cut yourself. Now this is my own technique of how I do Spanish omelet. You know, the way I used to do it is just by slicing this potatoes and cooking them for 21 minutes with the onions and then straining them out and then putting the egg and leaving them in the oven in the refrigerator for 10 minutes and then cooking them both sides 2 minutes. But if it's too much time consuming, you know, like people get hungry real fast. So I came up with a solution to cut my time short and to make it faster. But the cooking process is the slow part. So you want to be careful. You want to cut. So this potato has a little bit of darkness in it, which means it's either started to be getting not as fresh. So what you want to do is peel your potatoes. Don't forget to wash them. It's very important that you wash your potatoes. Just because you're peeling them does not mean that it's clean under the peel. Doesn't mean any of that. So this there, we got one more to go. Make sure you fill all your potatoes. Good. Last one. Make sure you pick up the peels if they miss the bowl, because then they'll dry up on the counter and it's going to be very hard for you guys to clean it afterwards. Take my word for it, because I've done that before and it was not a pretty picture in the end. Okay, so all potatoes are clean. I'm going to wash them because that's against the USDA not to wash fruits or vegetables. You have to make sure you wash your vegetables and fruits all the time, no matter what people tell you. Oh, we're running out of time. So you'd rather run out of time and get somebody sick? Nah. Okay. All vegetables. side of the grater. We're just gonna grate them onto this paper towel, two layers of paper towel. Same thing, if there's some that you can't do anymore because your fingers are getting too close to the grater, don't worry about it. Grinder, grater. It's a grater, not a grinder. This may take you a while, maybe 5 minutes. You don't have to be impatient, just take your time, no need to rush. So now that you've grated all of this beautiful Yukon potatoes, you are going to do as I'm going to show you. Take another layer of paper towel. You gotta place it on top. Squeeze, squeeze. Till you get the majority of the liquid out from the potatoes, because you don't want to have a wet omelet and not holding the form. So you want to make sure that you squeeze as much of the water content in the potatoes. Now, this is the tricky part. Now, this may be a little bit difficult for you guys because it is, you know, wet or moist. So you have to like really put it in there gently. Anything sticks to the paper towel, try to get as much as you can off. Okay. Now what you want to do is mix it together with the onions that you have inside. So it's nice and incorporated and combined. After you do this, you're going to break 6 eggs. And you always have to wash your hands. Doesn't matter what you're doing, washing your hands is like 80% in the kitchen. So now, what you want to do is break the eggs. One. Two. Three. Four. Again, because we just touched raw egg. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put some salt and pepper. Salt to taste. And I'm sure the amount of pudding in what I'm doing. Okay, and pepper. Now you would want to take a fork. In this situation, I would use a fork and beat the eggs. And we're going to start heating up the olive oil. Now that we got that in out of the way, we are going to use some all-purpose flour so it keeps it all together. And I don't know why I threw the fork, but I'll probably need to take a different fork now. So I'm using a quarter cup. This is just a way to keep it all together. So when it cooks, it doesn't separate, doesn't turn chunky. Looks like it did the job, so I'm gonna move you guys over here.
This is the pan right here.
So we're going to let the olive oil get hot. The way that I can tell if it's hot is by putting a little bit of salt, listening to any pop. It's not popping, but it feels from my instinct that it is ready. And in order to know if it's ready, we're going to take a bit here. Okay, it's sizzling, but it's not. It's not in the temperature that I want it to be. So we're going to hold on that for a little bit more. And don't forget to get a big plate, because you are going to have to put it above. And then flip it. Okay. Looks like it's ready. Let's pour it in here. All of it. We gotta move it around. Flatten it around. No, it doesn't matter. We don't need to add more. It's good as it is. We're gonna put a timer for 2 minutes.
Don't forget to rotate it.
How it looks,
and you will see how it would look when I flip it. I'm not flipping it like this. Don't get that idea. It's way too big. Not going to risk it doing this way. Hope it stays in the shape that you guys currently saw. I hope it stays that way. It looks very delicate. Might have not taken out enough water from the potatoes, but let's just cross our fingers and hope it all comes out good, okay? Smells amazing. I might have to move you guys a little bit further back, because when I have to flip it, I might have to do it right here.
Let's get the towels ready. 1 minute remaining.
Sorry about that. Got my towels ready. Let's add the plate on here already. Okay. Because we got 1 minute left, so we're getting ready to flip it. All right, time's up. Let's close the heat for now. Lift it up just to take a look. Okay, let's check how it is holding up. Okay, looks like it's doing a decent job. Okay, sorry guys, I don't know why it's squeaking so much. Okay, so let's do this. 3, 2, 1. Kind of nervous for some reason. 3, 2, 1. Now this is a little bit heavy for some reason. Go. You know what? Did keep the shape. You guys want to see the other side?
Yeah.
Okay. Look. That's how it looks so far. Let's put this bad boy back in the pan. Okay, oops, sorry guys, let's go rinse this out. Let's let it dry up, air dry. We will need this towel again. Let's set a timer for 3 minutes. And this time, you know what? I'm not gonna close it because I learned my mistake before and it made it very soft and like spongy. I don't want that.
seconds left. All right.
Let's flip this bad boy. I need to get the plate.
Now this is the final of the final presentation.
Let's check how it is. Feels very uniform. All right, there we go. So wrap this handle up. Move it over here. 3, 2, 1. Voila! Now that is a Spanish omelet. Sorry for moving too fast with my camera. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate everything that you are doing. I appreciate your support, love, and all the comments and subscriptions that you're doing to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification button. More videos are on the way.